So when it comes to 3D in PowerPoint, you essentially have two options. You can select a model from PowerPoint's 3D library, but honestly, it might not have exactly what you need. Or you can create your own custom 3D object using shapes. For example, this is a flat or 2D column chart, and here is the same chart, but in 3D. To create a 3D column, go to Shapes, click on Diamond, hold down Shift key and draw a diamond, something like this. After that, click on Rectangle and draw a column. Make sure its width aligns with the center of the diamond. If done correctly, then as you increase the height of the rectangle, it should fit perfectly with the tip of the diamond. And when you send it to back, like a puzzle, it starts coming together. Now at this point, we need to duplicate the diamond and move it to the bottom of the column. Take note of how I place it. Before we move on, let's create another copy of that diamond. We'll need it in a bit. Hold down Shift key and select all three shapes. Go to Mesh Shapes and select Fragment. Delete the parts you don't need and slide the diamond back to its original position. It should align perfectly with the rectangle. To complete the shape, duplicate the rectangle, flip it vertically and position it on the left side of the diamond. Now we can change the fill colors of the shapes to give them that 3D appearance. And once you are satisfied, select all three shapes and group them together. From here forward, you can try different 3D rotations and the shape will follow your lead. Now let me show you another example where I created a stack of bricks. First, I drew the diamond. Then I used Freeform from Shapes to draw a slanted rectangle. I duplicated and flipped the rectangle vertically before placing it on the other side of the diamond. And the rest was just a matter of tweaking the colors and duplicating the shapes to arrive at this result. In future videos, we will look at more advanced examples of 3D, so stay tuned